Shalom, shalom, Shabbat Adonai. Welcome to the Sixth Exodus program. Thank you for listening. The name of this segment is Judah and Jerusalem. Judah and Jerusalem. All right, let's begin. The word of the Lord for the people of God. I'll read to you the book of Isaiah, chapter 2, in its entirety. There will be no comments afterwards. The word that Isaiah, the son of Amoz, saw concerning Judah and Jerusalem. And it shall come to pass in the last days that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established in the top of the mountains and shall be exalted above the hills, and all nations shall flow unto it. And many people shall go and say, Come ye, and let us go unto the mountain of the Lord, to the house of the God of Jacob. And he will teach us his laws and his ways, and we will walk in his path. For out of Zion shall go forth the law in the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. And he shall judge among the nations, and shall rebuke many people, and they shall beat their swords into plowshares, and their spears into pruning hooks. Nations shall not lift up sword against nations, neither shall they learn war anymore. O house of Jacob, come ye, and let us walk in the light of the Lord. Therefore thou hast forsaken thy people, the house of Jacob, because they be replenished from the east, and are soothsayers like the Philistines. And they pleased themselves in the children of strangers. Their land also is full of silver and gold, neither is there any end to their treasures. Their land is also full of horses, neither is there any end of their chariots. Their land also is full of idols. They worship the works of their own hands, that which their own fingers have made. And the mean man boweth down, and the great man humbles himself. Therefore forgive them not. Enter into the rock and hide thee in the dust for fear of the Lord and for the glory of his majesty. The lofty looks of man shall be humbled, and the haughtiness of man shall be bowed down, and the Lord alone shall be exalted in that day. For the day of the Lord of hosts shall be upon everyone that is proud and lofty, and upon everyone that is lifted up. And he shall be brought low, and upon all the cedars of Lebanon that are high and lifted up, and upon all the oaks of Bashan, and upon all the high mountains, and upon all the hills that are lifted up, and upon every high tower, and upon every fence walled, and upon all the ships of Tarshish, and upon all the pleasant pictures, and the loftiness of man shall be bowed down, and the haughtiness of men shall be made low, and the Lord alone shall be exalted in that day, and the idols he shall utterly abolish. And they shall go into the holes of the rocks, and into the caves of the earth, for the fear of the Lord, and for the fear of the glory of his majesty, when he arises to shake terribly the earth. In that day a man shall cast his idols of silver and his idols of gold, which they have made each one for himself to worship, to the moles and to the bats, to go into the cliffs of the rocks and into the top of the ragged rocks, for fear of the Lord and for the glory of his majesty, when he arises to shake terribly the earth. Ceasing from men whose breath is in his nostrils, for wherein is he to be accounted of? Okay. Thank you for listening. Have a great day.